Hello everyone, welcome to the fourth tutorial of Math 2 Week 1. So in this video we will consider a function fx equal to floor of x and try to see its behavior and try to see limit of this function at some point. So at first let me write it down. This is called floor of x. So Sir has already taught this function in the lecture. So what is this function? What is the functional value of this? So fx is a if x lies between a and a plus 1. So and a is an integer. So what does this mean? It means that fx is nothing but the greatest integer less than or equal x. So this is the definition of floor function. Suppose I have 2.7, then f of 2.7 is nothing but 2. But if I have f of 3, then it will be 3. If I have f of 3.2, then it will be 3 again. So you can see that this function is basically giving us a constant value in some interval, where if we take the interval as 2, 3 and 3 is open here, so we are including 2 and make 3 as open, then fx equal to 2. Similarly 3 for 3, 4. So it's basically a for a plus 1. That's we have written here. Okay, so let us try to see the graphical visualization of this function. Okay, so graph of this function will look like this shape. So there are a jump in each integer. So in between 0 and 1, the functional value is 0. In between 1 and 2, the functional value is 1. In between 2 and 3, the functional value is 2. So we are including the left side integer and excluding the right side integer in some interval, as we have written earlier. So this is how the function looks like. Now, if we want to compute the limit at some point, let us say at 0, what will be the limit? So what will be the functional value as it approaches towards 0, as we approach towards 0? So we can approach to 0 from both left hand side and right hand side, and let us see what happens. So we consider the equation, consider the straight line x equal to 1. This is the straight line. So at x equal to 1, the functional value is 1. And x equal to minus 1, the functional value is minus 1. Now if we approach towards 0 from this right hand side and left hand side, let us see what happens. So you can see as we are approaching from the right hand side, the functional value is approaching towards 0, but as we are approaching from the left hand side, the functional value is approaching towards minus 1, as that's how the function, the floor function, is defined. And we can see as we are approaching towards 0, from right hand side the functional value is near to 0, and from the left hand side the functional value is near to minus 1. So there is no unique value which we get by approaching from both left hand side and right hand side. So in this case, this function has no limit at the point 0, and this will happen for each point, each integer. As you can see, at each integer, if we approach from left and if we approach from right, will appear in two different values. That's why the limit does not exist at the integer. Thank you.